Hello, everyone, and welcome to SCI-Arc 2020 Commencement. I'm Hernán Díaz Alonso, I'm the director of school, and I'm thrilled to say that we are safely live from SCI-Arc with the students, faculty, trustees, staffs, friends, and families turning virtually from all over the world. Clearly, things look a little different this year. I wish that we could all be together in person to celebrate you, the extraordinary class of 2020. But I want to convey on how proud we are, how proud the entire community has navigated this challenging and unexpected time. I'm confident as we work through together, through this process of creativity, compassion, optimism, and civic responsibilities, this shall pass and we will emerge on the other end stronger than before. I want to especially thank you, our graduating students, for your phenomenal, extraordinary work, not this year, but through your studies at SCI-Arc. We could not be more excited or filled with more pride and hope to see you move through what has been the combination of your SCI-Arc career, compounded by soldiering through of incredibly challenging times. I cannot think more difficult times than this one that we're going through. But also, this is proof that no matter the situation, no matter what obstacles we are presenting with, being an architect is about navigating the reality that we are part of it in order to shape it the larger context. An opportunity you have each embraced in unparalleled ways. From a global pandemic that we're still going through to a national unraising for racial justice, black lives, and unrepresented communities and BIPOC. This has been an extraordinary time of reckoning and waking up for us as a society, which means also that now more than ever, we must remember that the aim of architecture is its best and most fundamental is to make the world better than how we found it. The work that you've done through your SCI-Arc career has shown that possibility in space, which it gives us a great sense of optimism and courage moving forward to see what you're capable of doing. You, the class of 2020, are a remarkable group of students. We are honored to be able to witness the ideas that you cultivated during your time at SCI-Arc. Flourish and develop from here forward, it will be up to you. We will be keeping on you, we will keep reaching out to you, we will keep engaging you. On behalf of the entire SCI-Arc community, I want to extend our pride and admiration to you. Thank you and congratulations. I want to say also that you as a class, it reminds us to keep thinking and to keep looking at ourselves, who we are as an institution. These have been extraordinary times and they've been great partners, and you guys have been great partners with us. We will never forget that. We have an exciting avenue ahead, so let's get to it. Welcome back. I'm very pleased to introduce our commencement speaker, Dr. Safiya Umoja Noble. Dr. Noble is an associate professor at UCLA in the Department of Information Studies, where she serves as the co-director of the UCLA Center for Critical Internet Inquiry. She also holds appointment in African American Studies and Gender Studies. She is a newly appointed research associate to the Oxford Internet Institute and the University of Oxford. Safiya is the author of a best-selling book on racist and sexist algorithm bias in commercial search engines, entitled Algorithm of Oppression, How Search Engines Reinforce Racism. Safiya is the recipient of a Hellman Fellowship at the UCLA Early Career Award. Her academic research focuses on the design of digital media platforms on the internet and their impact on society. Her work is both sociological and interdisciplinary, making the ways that digital media impact and intersect with issues of race, gender, culture, and technology. Please join me in welcoming Dr. Noble.
Hello, my name is Safiya Noble. I'm an associate professor at UCLA, and I'm here to congratulate the friends, the family, the children, the partners, and most of all, the graduates of SCI-Arc 2020. This is your day, and I'm so thrilled to be a part of it, even though it's not the way I had envisioned it, with us all gathering together in your beautiful campus in downtown LA. But short of that, I hope that I can share a few words of encouragement for you as you celebrate this incredible, incredible day. You know, 2020 has dealt us some blows, hasn't it? It's really been a challenging year on many fronts. In fact, technology has been kind of a core feature of the way in which we've been keeping our connections, continuing to learn, lamenting, cocktail houring, doing all of the things, of course, including your amazing projects and the things that you have created and developed while a student at SCI-Arc. So there's something that's, you know, still full of possibility about the ways in which we can engage and imagine and create. Now, my work has been focused on technology. I've really spent the last decade thinking about not just the affordances, but also some of the consequences or some of the limits of the way that these new moments that we're living in, that are in many ways so deeply facilitated by technology, also create limits on what we can do. And so I want to just spend a couple of minutes encouraging you as you celebrate this incredible day, and to offer a moment of reflection and maybe some words of advice that you can carry forward, building on all the things that you've already learned at SCI-Arc. You know, one of the things that I think that's so powerful that you've learned at a place like SCI-Arc is that you've already taken it into your own hands to embrace a transformative kind of educational experience. You are at a place that is encouraging you and has encouraged you to think critically, to look for places where you may not have looked for answers or possibilities before. And I think there's something that is so special that you can carry with you from this kind of educational experience that you've had at SCI-Arc. And I certainly envy it myself. I'm so envious of your faculty and the kinds of work that you've been able to think about in these kinds of transformative and non-traditional ways. You know, but even as we kind of think about these transformative possibilities that stem from this accomplishment of graduating from SCI-Arc, or the kinds of innovative technological and artistic and creative projects that you've developed, we always find ourselves bumping up against limits. You know, sometimes we find the limits on accident. In my case, I started my research as a graduate student looking at the limits of things like search engines and how limiting they were in opening up worlds of knowledge, for example, and really keeping us so much more closely tied to advertising and other kinds of corporate interests. It hadn't occurred to me until I started to look for myself and my community and people that I cared about that I saw the limits in the technical system called a search engine. And you know, it's not that those things didn't exist before I looked at them. It's that I looked at them through the lens of my own experience, of my own identity, of my community, of my family. And I asked different questions of the technological engagements that I was experiencing. And this is where I saw just how flawed so many of the systems that we are working with are. And so this is where I want to invite you as you embark on your own journeys, leaving the programs, that you think about centering people that you might not have centered before. You know, in the case of the many crises that we're starting to see around big technology companies, and these are crises like predictive policing or criminal sentencing software or the use of social media to undermine democracy. I mean, these are really important and substantive issues. And part of the reason that we've come to understand them as issues is because the people who are most vulnerable are the people who've been asking questions about how these technologies get used against them. And so I want to invite you to remember that while it might be that we are in these protected spaces that feel innovative and interesting, like being able to have deliver a commencement speech over a video recording, you know, there are so many other ways in which people don't experience these kinds of affordances or these kinds of possibilities. They, in fact, experience very, very different and many times harmful kinds of implementations of technological solutions. So I invite you to be thinking about that. You know, one of the things that is foundational to the way that we think about the future is that we are born into systems and structures. You could almost think of them as models. Someone had a vision for how our societies and our communities would be organized. And we are confined in many ways by the limits of the models, the limits of what could have been, but wasn't pursued. And so this is where I invite you to think about, where are the values? What are the values in the models that you're developing as you move into new projects and new experiences? Have you stopped to think about what values you hold and how you might organize your own work around those values? Many of the values and the models in computing, in entertainment, in education, politics, you know, healthcare, many of these models are indeed failing us. They're just insufficient to meet the needs of the majority of people in our society. And so I think this is an incredible time to graduate from college, quite frankly. It's an incredible moment in 2020 when so many systems and projects are failing to step into the vacuum and to envision and propose and to organize and to enact new kinds of value-based systems. And this to me is one of the most exciting possibilities around graduating from college. It's just, it's like a moment where we get to imagine a future for ourselves that maybe the world doesn't always encourage us to do. All right. So as you go into this brand new world of possibility, as you hug, I hope, and hold close to you all of the people who have made this incredible accomplishment come into fruition, I hope that you will think about the challenges that you've experienced along the way. You know, those challenges, it's in the challenges, it's in the rub, it's in the fracture, it's in the hardness, the hard times that we find our way forward. And of course, collectively, many societies around the world, we are feeling the rub, we are feeling the fracture, we are feeling the hardness. And this is indeed a powerful moment and a powerful year for moving forward, new ideas, and again, new possibilities. Now, I think, you know, one of the last things I want to say to you is that we're counting on you. No pressure, but we are. We're really counting on you to step forward powerfully. And I'll tell you that I know in my own experience, you know, I was the first generation in my family to go to college, and no one had a blueprint for me to tell me how to do it, how to pay for it, how to get it done, how to succeed. I didn't know enough about how to prepare for things like graduate school or the workforce. I was really kind of like, you know, many people, left to my own devices to try to figure it out. And one of the things that I think is so amazing in this moment that we're in is that we have more and more information and knowledge at our fingertips to help us collectively advance, move forward, be supported. You know, I often thought as I was finishing college that it would be the people above me who would decide the fate of my future, right? The people in power, the people with authority over me. But what I've learned in my many years now on the planet is that it's actually been the people next to me and the people behind me who have pushed me forward, who have grabbed my arm and said, come on, sis, we're going to make this happen together. And so I encourage you, if there's anything that you can do as you complete this amazing journey and graduate, that you hold on to each other, that you take your crew, your peers, your friends, your comrades with you into the future, and that you together organize, strategize, support, laugh, cry, do all the things together with the people who you believe in and who push you to think more deeply and more powerfully and more potently about this time that you have to be alive and to live out your purpose. You know, a lot of people are waiting for you. Indeed, your being here, your being a part of SCI-Arc, our opportunity to know you and to connect with you and to launch you into the world is no coincidence. Everybody is where they should be. Everybody is where they need to be. And this is an important, incredible springboard moment into the now. You know, the future is not tomorrow. The future is right now. And so I hope that you will cherish these bonds that you've made, that you will continue to cultivate your intellectual and creative capacities, and that you will support each other's dreams. We're living in a time where a lot of us feel that the time for dreaming is too hard. But, you know, as I look out, I watch the news, I watch the streets, I see what's happening in my own community, in the struggles for racial justice, in the struggles around the world for economic justice. You know, this is the moment where there's so much possibility to create and design a world that benefits Earth and all of its inhabitants. And so I want to just, again, congratulate you on taking a path in your own life that will lead you somewhere profoundly, remarkably different than maybe the people in your life ever thought. You know, I'll tell you that I went to, when I went to college, you know, there were, and it, you know, this wasn't so long ago, but you know, there weren't always people who could tell me what the pathway forward would be. And if with my own students at UCLA, I see so much angst and so much anxiety about the future and becoming and being great and being the best and being on top. And, you know, if there were any advice that I could give to you, it would be to just let go of the pressure and find ways and people to energize your ideas, to bring you up and to motivate you. Let the pain of the world, the injustices of the world motivate you to improve, make things better, contribute, be part of solutions. You know, it life to me and these kinds of incredible benchmark accomplishments are really about marking the persistence, marking that we can start a thing and we can finish a thing. We can see something for ourselves with no evidence of it even being possible, and we can trust a process and move through it and look back and say, I did that thing. You know, that's one of the most important to me dimensions of getting an education through all of these various formal channels. It just reminds us how powerful we are, that we can just decide and declare and do. So I want to congratulate you for deciding to go to SCI-Arc, for moving through it, moving through the challenges, for doing it. You did that. You did that. And that is incredible. I wish I could be with you. I wish that we were not living in the time where we can no longer hug it out, because if I could, I would just hug it out with you and say, you know, we did this. And we have so much more to do, and we can do it, and we're doing it. Congratulations, friends, family, partners, children, most importantly, graduates of SCI-Arc 2020. You did that.
Thank you, Dr. Safiya Noble. It's hard to imagine anybody better than you to talk to us in this particular time in terms of inspiration, challenges, and how we can approach the intersection of all these worlds that we want to be part of it. We really, really appreciate you taking the time and come and talk to our graduates. Looking forward to see you soon. Let me introduce the next of our speakers. This is the alumna speaker. I'm very happy and proud to introduce an astonishing graduate alumna from the house, from SCI-Arc, Debbie Garcia. Deborah Garcia is a Los Angeles-based designer, writer, and curator. She holds a Master of Architecture from Princeton University and a Bachelor of Architecture from SCI-Arc. She was the recipient of the Princeton University Butler Traveling Fellowship, which took her to the Corporate Agriculture Complex of the United States Heartland, where she was a resident at R Farm, Nebraska, and was an invited participant for the 2019 Arctic Circle Expedition in the international territorial of Svalbard, Norway. She was a co-curator of the drawing show at the A+D Museum, Architecture and Design Museum in 2017, and curator of One Night at Stanford Art and Architecture LA in 2016. She is currently the Marion Mahoney Emerging Practitioner Fellow at the MIT Department of Architecture. Debbie Garcia.
In 1968, Bill Anders took the image AS08122383 while aboard the Apollo 8 spacecraft. The photograph was taken in lunar orbit on Christmas Eve, 1968. 13 days earlier, Japan's greatest heist, the still unsolved 300 million yen robbery, occurs in Tokyo. And 12 days before, the US performs a nuclear test in Nevada. Exactly 1 month before Bill Anders points his Hasselblad 500 EL camera out of the Apollo 8's left rendezvous window, Yale University announces, for the first time in its history, the admission of women. And 10 days before that, Captain Kirk and Uhura share the first interracial kiss to be ever broadcast on American television. The photograph Bill Anders took on December 24, 1968, as the Apollo 8 made its fourth rotation around the far side of the moon, was of the Earth, suddenly appearing in the darkness. I would like to think that in that moment, and from that angle, and from a distance of over 240,000 miles from home, images of these events might have flashed before Bill Anders' eyes, like a fantastical slideshow of our smallness in the universe, our great adventures and tragedies and ignorance played at a cosmic scale before him. He saw more than he could understand, more than he could digest, and I like to think that as Bill Anders looked at that pale blue dot suspended in the darkness, that he felt not only small, but strange. And perhaps when he came back, that strangeness remained, and he never again felt quite at home here. The strangeness came back with him, and it grew bigger and stronger, and a year later, David Bowie sang about it too. planet Earth is blue, and there's nothing I can do. You too are far from home. Not the home you were born into, but the home that became a home after endless days and nights spent within its walls. At least it did for me. A home that was also a hallway, from one end to the other, spanning a quarter mile long, and I would think, it's gonna be a while till I get there. But it was not a while at all. 5 years of my architectural education flew by in a moment, and in an instant, I was suddenly 2,742 miles from home when I went to grad school and I pretended I too could be a prince. Princeton was in every way what home was not. I read books instead of using them as elaborate support structures. We spoke about radical matters rather than radical materials. But I could not shake where I was from, and at the end of it all, I was the last one to leave the studio at night and the first one to arrive in the morning, because those were the rhythms I had learned here. I pondered without reserve, and I asked questions without fear, because I had first exercised that here. I'm sure that SCI-Arc has changed much since I left. In fact, it would seem that transformation at the speed of light is its greatest strength. I used to joke that a sick day could take you out of the game here. A couple days in bed with the flu meant lifetimes had passed in the halls of this school. A year ago, I was 4,518 miles from home, aboard a sailing vessel in the Arctic Ocean. We sailed until we reached the northernmost functional civilian settlement in the world and traveled by foot to the northernmost climate and environment research center in the Arctic Circle, where two weather balloons are released daily to collect atmospheric data. A young Canadian researcher asked me if I'd like to release the balloon. I tried to look cool, as if it were no big deal. And we watched together as the balloon begins its ascent. A couple hours later, a fellow researcher points out that the young Canadian scientist and I might be the only brown people this far up north at that very moment. I tell her, I know that feeling well by now. As the balloon rose into the stratosphere, it prepared itself for a quick and honorable end at 105,000 feet of elevation. On its way up, it enjoyed the view, taking in the seemingly endless expanse of pack ice and then rising further still beyond the clouds so high that it encountered the Earth as very few have, from a perspective outside the boundary of human existence. From here, the world only gets smaller, and what is beyond exponentially expands into oblivion. Today in this moment, we acknowledge the world that you come into. A difficult environment with treacherous terrain, it hides both wonder and hostility. We acknowledge that you, after your time here, now set forth into a world unlike the one your predecessors faced when they too had to leave this place. But you are also equipped, smart, vigilant, flexible, weary, resilient in ways that have not been seen before. You leave home now, but you already left on March 6th, 2020, when the halls of the school that we occupy like our home closed its doors amid a pandemic. You receive a marker upon the completion of your education today, but you and I both know that we each reckoned with this before anyone gave us a piece of paper acknowledging what we did here. You have already come to terms with the completion of your time here in the thesis arguments each of you have thoughtfully and carefully constructed. Today, in this moment, we acknowledge that you are done here for now, but that this school will always remain a home to those who continue to imagine what this world might one day be, and to take on the adventures and tragedies and ignorance of what the world is now. You must love the world enough to struggle with it. This has always been at the heart of the school and continues to be. Take this time now and look back upon the home you are leaving, knowing that you can only return to it like a stranger in a strange land. It will change without you, and you will change without it, and you leave home to find, join, make another. Congratulations, class of 2020. We acknowledge you and celebrate you together from afar.
Thank you, Debbie. We couldn't be more proud of the work that you danced in your graduate from SCI-Arc. And of course, your commencement speech was unique, as you are. The last of our speakers is the student speaker. And I'm thrilled to introduce Vincent Young. Vincent Young is a designer from Vancouver, Canada. He is a master student of SCI-Arc at the MR1 Academic Counselor for the Student Union. His graduate thesis, Walk This Way, addresses the role of the community centers and a space for collective healing and action. He's currently the coordinator of the 123 Make High School Workshop with the Institute of Educational Advancement. Vincent has previously designed at several LA-based firms, including TextaWiser and Spinagoo. His photography has been featured in many Canadian publications, including Shift Magazine, In Root Magazine, and exhibited in Brooklyn, New York at the Photobile Photography Exhibition. Currently, he is in quarantine. Vincent likes to eat kimchi fried rice, sit next to the air conditioner, and water his seven house plants. Please join me in welcoming our extraordinary student speaker, Vincent Young.
Hey, hi, hello. Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to everyone joining in from around the world. Thank you for showing up and being here today to celebrate the SCI-Arc graduating class of 2020. I want to recognize what an incredible journey we have all been through to get here. To my mom, dad, and sister watching from Vancouver, 多谢晒. I promise to translate this speech to Cantonese so you, mom and dad, can understand how thankful I am for your support. For those who don't know me, my name is Vincent Young, and I'm a master's student at SCI-Arc. I am honored to be speaking to you as a proud gay Chinese Canadian and a son of immigrants. I would like to start by thanking the administrative team for maneuvering us through these turbulent times. Thank you for working with the student union and maintaining SCI-Arc as a world-class architectural institution. To the SCI-Arc staff, thank you for being so incredibly accommodating. I know we aren't easy to take care of. Whether it's sending us emails, making sure loose blades are picked up off the ground, making sure 11x17 paper is at the fishbowl, making sure I don't chop off my hand with a bandsaw, I speak on behalf of the graduating class. Thank you for all your work. To the faculty, thank you for keeping conversations alive. Watching you work has shown us that to create a meaningful career is to pursue a lifelong project, turning personal interest into an architectural practice. Now, to the graduating class of 2020. We did it. We did it. We did it. We dedicated so much time, energy, and attention to filling the school with a sense of purpose and excitement. I would like to remind all of you that we have stayed up late waiting for our models to dry in the spray booths. We have gone home with the lingering scent of MaxiCure and Accelerator on our clothes. We asked each other, can you tell me if this is straight, while pinning up for a VS review. We accidentally walked into Keck while a lecture was happening and tiptoed to the other side. We have bravely presented our work online and embraced the challenge of a completely new workflow. Give yourself a pat on the back, text a friend saying we did it, because we truly deserve to celebrate our accomplishments right now. Seriously, private message on Zoom or message in Twitch saying we did it. I will never forget the first day of studio where I met all my classmates for the first time. We were timid, quiet, nervous, unsure of where to put our belongings. How does the Wi-Fi work? Is there an elevator? Where is the bathroom? we quickly realized the mountain of plywood in front of us were actually stacks of studio desks. In pairs, we unstacked the plywood tables and placed them on top of the side cabinets. Everyone had their own set. We had to agree on which way to face our desks and where we would place the shared work tables. This building of our studio created a comfortable shared space and was the beginning of understanding how we could care for each other. Slowly, the unfamiliar and scary became familiar and safe. This is what we have been doing in our time at SCI-Arc. This is an architectural practice, a practice of building. When we face the unfamiliar, caring for one another and creating comfortable shared space makes familiarity and safety possible. I remember my first pinup in South Gallery and being horrified by not knowing how to speak about my work. I was smiling and nodding at the jury, only to go back to my desk and realize I had no clue what I wrote down. This was a period of time that when I look back, I see us normalizing discomfort towards trying new things. To quote the amazing Dr. Brené Brown, an American professor and lecturer on the power of vulnerability, please check out her Netflix special. It's amazing. To be in the arena is to be brave with our lives. And when we make the choice to dare greatly, we sign up to get our asses kicked. We can choose courage or we can choose comfort, but we can't have both, not at the same time. I see studio as this arena. It is both the site of courage and comfort. It is a site where we feel joy and pain. By continuing to show up to studio is to practice normalizing the discomfort of doing unfamiliar things again. When the pandemic took over and shifted our world, once again, we practiced normalizing discomfort. It felt harder than ever to just nod and smile, but we have been there before. We were not strangers to spatial discomfort. We were able to carry on and make a plan on how to rebuild. I want to recognize the work of the amazing student union team. Wesley, Joy, Julian, Alonso, Liu, Allen, Asya, Corey, Max, Jesse, Olivia, Mateus, Essen, Wendy, and so many more. Thank you for showing up, volunteering your time, and doing work to prioritize student issues. By prioritizing student issues, we rearranged hierarchies, and it showed that sometimes the most powerful mentorship can be lateral. This summer, the student union confronted the embedded inequities in architecture. The tragic deaths of Breonna Taylor and George Floyd reignited necessary conversations of anti-racism around the world, within this country, and is, as always, our responsibility in the SCI-Arc community. We witnessed them, reflected them back, and asked questions. Fridays at 5 became a weekly Zoom call where we could discuss and educate ourselves on the pervasive nature of systemic racism, the way brutality against our Black and Indigenous peers is by design. We took action by organizing towards change in our curriculum and community. These meetings were, for me, again a way to normalizing discomfort. These conversations must continue and become familiar to all of us, because Black lives matter not just when we're comfortable with it. A few highlights from these meetings include Olivia presenting Norma Merrick Sklarik, the first African-American female architect licensed in the state of California. We had Lee and Richard educating us on queer Black histories, as well as Alan running donation drives for Feed the Streets LA. Also, shout out to Olivia for starting Design Students for Action. That's amazing. I saw amazing students rise up and show leadership, empathy, and bravery during times of crisis, pain, and discomfort. I am inspired by all of you. Thank you. To the continuing students, embrace the locality of your work. Understand that even though we aren't together in studio, you can still build an arena of courage and comfort for yourself. Remember, we have done it before. Doing my thesis this summer from home, I've learned a few lessons. Lesson number one, self-care is the most important priority. Nothing can happen without it. Remember that your health is important and that going outside, talking to a friend, getting sleep is more important than making a model or producing a drawing in isolation. Lesson number two, communication is work. As students, we're constantly gossiping. I mean, constantly communicating with one another. But over the past 6 months, checking in on one another and strengthening our support system has become essential. Even though we are apart, we could not have done it without each other. I suggest an open studio call similar to the one Kumaran set up for grad thesis. Lesson number three, done is better than perfect. Say it with me. Done is better than perfect. Shout out to my therapist in Toronto, who I still FaceTime weekly, for reminding me that I am my own harshest critic. And I know many of you are also your own harshest critic. But here we are, at the end of our time at SCI-Arc. Our graduation from SCI-Arc would have felt uncertain under any circumstance. But now we're not only leaving with uncertainty, we're leaving knowing how resilient we really are. I miss seeing all of you in person, and I know finding closure to our time together has been difficult. Like many of you, I don't know where I'll be or what I'll be doing a few months from now, but beyond that anxiety, I find it's incredibly exciting. What we leave behind at SCI-Arc gives us room to consider new things, to occupy our arena. For me, I see myself focusing on lesson number one, self-care. I'm focusing on what brings me joy. I plan on doing more ceramics, performing comedy, and going swimming once the pools open up. I know from talking to many of you, that's a similar idea of self-care that we're all gonna take. But it's important to remind ourselves that we have been here before. Remember that feeling of being in front of our first jury. You can't remember what you wrote down. You just smile and nod. We have practiced doing unfamiliar things. We have turned personal interest into an architectural practice. We have practiced so many unfamiliar things that trust that you have everything you need to continue. If SCI-Arc was a mountain, we've made it to the other side. No matter where you go from here, remember to always be in the arena, to show up and be courageous. Thank you so much. Woo!
Hi, everyone. I'm Wesley Evans. I'm an MArch1, and I'm the president of the student union at present. And I'm just going to read a statement that we've prepared together to sort of introduce this session and this day and our intentions. So I'll begin. The student union at SCI-Arc was established to organize student action, align student intention, and facilitate student awareness. We now understand that as a collectivist body of compassionate minds, we have an inherent responsibility to act on behalf of, and for the direct benefit of, a scope of citizenry that is much larger than just our little institution. This is to say that now, but in fact at all times, we must always be committed to the prevention of violence against Black and Brown bodies in this city of Los Angeles and across the country and the world.
Thank you, Vincent. We will miss you, Saya, but know that you're on to great things. Also, thank you to Wesley on behalf of the student union. We will keep working with you, the student union, to keep making SCI-Arc better, more equal, more fair, more inclusive. Now I would like to introduce our Vice Director and Chief Academic Officer, my dear, dear friend, our fantastic Vice Director, John Enright.
Thank you, Hernán. I want to thank all of our speakers today. And now I have the pleasure of announcing a series of awards to the students of the 2020 graduating class. These students showed exceptional merit during their tenure at SCI-Arc, and we wish to acknowledge their high level of dedication, commitment to the school, and their architectural education. The first set of awards are the SCI-Arc Service Awards. The SCI-Arc Service Award goes to graduate and undergraduate students who made outstanding contributions in the area of service to the SCI-Arc community, as selected by the chairs, faculty, and staff. The SCI-Arc Service Award in the B-Arc program goes to Alejandro Lohr. The SCI-Arc Service Award in the M-Arc 1 program goes to Joy Day. The SCI-Arc Service Award in the M-Arc 2 program goes to Jonathan Warner. And now we'll award the Alpha Rho Chi Medal. Since 1914, Alpha Rho Chi, the National Professional Fraternity for Architecture and the Allied Arts, has promoted the profession of architecture by encouraging students to excel. To honor their achievements, the Alpha Rho Chi Medal is offered each year to over 100 schools of architecture, whose faculty select a graduating senior they feel best exemplifies these qualities. In 1931, the Grand Council of Alpha Rho Chi established the Alpha Rho Chi Medal to encourage professional leadership by rewarding student accomplishment. The fraternity provides the medal to selected schools of architecture throughout the country to be awarded to the graduating senior who has shown an affinity for leadership, performed willing service for the school or department, and gives promise of real professional merit through his or her attitude and personality. This year's Alpha Rho Chi Medal goes to Nancy I of the B-Arc program. And now I'm pleased to announce the AIA Henry Adams Medals. Each year, the American Institute of Architects awards an engraved Medal of Merit to the top-ranking graduating student in each architecture program accredited by the National Architectural Accrediting Board. These awards are provided as part of the AIA AAF Scholarship Program. The AIA Henry Adams Medal in the B-Arc program goes to Nancy I. The AIA Henry Adams Medal in the M-Arc program goes to Christina Griggs in M-Arc 2. Please join me in giving a collective round of applause to all of our winners.
It was just a few years ago when I was in front of you in Keck Hall welcoming you to SCI-Arc. At that time, the Office of Admissions had a message for you all, and that was that we were confident that you had all the skill sets and qualities to be successful at SCI-Arc. Now, we're honored again to be in front of you, this time with the same message. We know that you are resilient and hardworking, and we are confident that you will be successful on the next step of your journey. So with that said, the Office of Admissions would like to say, congrats.
Class.
2020!
Congratulations, class of 2020. It has been a real joy knowing many of you from the very beginning and seeing you develop over the past 3 years. And I am super excited to see what happens over the next three. Good luck.
Hey, everyone. Congratulations. I can't tell you how rewarding it's been for me to have witnessed your talents throughout the years
You've made lasting impressions on all of us at the school. I really wish you all the best in your future, and hopefully we will get to see each other in person soon.
Hello. The shop staff would like to offer a hearty congratulations to the class of 2020. It's been our distinct pleasure to have worked with each and every one of you. And we truly appreciate you giving us the opportunity to have been part of your academic journey here at SCI-Arc. We wish you nothing but great success and dreams fulfilled. We hope the experiences you gained in the shop only help propel you in your future work. Way to go, class of 2020.
And now we are pleased to confer the diplomas onto the 2020 graduating class as awarded by our program chairs. Tom Wiscombe, Chair of the B-Arc Program, Elena Manfredini, Chair of the M-Arc Programs, and David Rue, Chair of the Postgraduate Programs.
Hi, I'm Tom Wiscombe, Chair of the Undergraduate Program at SCI-Arc. Our program is focused on imagination and disruptive thinking. Easy to say, hard to foster, probably impossible to institutionalize, really. But there's nothing more important today. Disruption, imagination. One breaks things down, the other builds things up. Neither fares well within ideological bubbles that generalize, categorize, and exclude. Disruption cuts through bubbles so imagination can flow in unexpected ways. This graduating class, you all, is tenacious, opinionated, and savvy. It's been amazing watching you grow up and construct yourselves and your community. Rather than taking the summer off before your thesis year, you began thesis in the middle of summer 2019. Grassroots, you couldn't wait. It started as a discussion of affinities at long dinner tables, a community spirit that is rare and beautiful and thoughtful. It was a moment of coming together and realizing that your interests were not private ones, but rather part of a shared time, a shared ethics, but expressed through radically different aesthetic affinities. Happily, there were battles of ideas all summer and into the year, about everything really, which I loved because it means you are operating from built-up points of view and a learned state of fearlessness. I can't imagine a better outcome for an undergraduate program today. I hope for you all that you can continue your community together as a force. I'm talking about power, not just staying connected, which is the new normal. I'm talking about action that can be in the form of building offices together, inventing a new aesthetic realm or building type, or altogether realigning architecture's role in society. That is not a Facebook group. That is a tribe. Your tribe is a tribe of builders. A lot has been torn down or broken this year. Some of it dismantling unethical systems, some of it just pure wanton destruction. Now it is time to build again. Building is a form of optimism, and I hope for your class and the next that you can stay focused on showing us what the world should look like. This time is not about fantasy, it's about concreteness and landing concrete ideas on the ground. With that, I want to congratulate our undergraduate class of 2020.
How's it?
It's hot, man.
Action.
Anna Antoni, class of 2020.
Diana Ansarut Sarai. We made it, guys.
Dusha Brown.
Tiziana Felice.
Alexander Kardanovsky.
Shayan Khorasani.
Pause. Jabba. Pause. Pause. Chakaman. Pause. Jabba. Pause. Chakaman. Pause. Jabba. Pause. Picture perfect.
Aaron Kumar.
Hi everyone, Kjin D 2020.
Q Lim.
Hi, my name is Yipeng from BARC program class of 2020.
Alejandro Lord.
I am Bao Lu from BARC program class of 2020.
Congrats, class of 2020.
True and all.
BBLA in class of 2020.
Hi, my name is Hongjian Chen.
Austin James Ross, 2020.
Hello, class of 2020 SCI-Arc, huh? My name is Navid Samanian, and thank you all for the amazing journey.
Saring and Sinaraja.
Anastasia Tokmakova.
Nino Vidanovich.
Hi, my name is Kiwi Zixiaoju, and congratulations for all of us.
Hi, my name is Elena Manfredini. I am the graduate program chair here at SCI-Arc. 2020 has been a year we will all remember. This is especially true for our graduate students who have been working remotely on their thesis this summer. A thesis, by definition, is a culmination of an academic career. And it is a time to question the reality around us. After months of a global pandemic and social awakening, our entire community at large has been faced with the same urgent need to redefine what we do as architects and how we contribute to our society. Today, we, along with the students, need to graduate to a different future. During the past month, I had the privilege to look at the students' work streaming from all around the globe in different time zones against green screens and virtual backgrounds. The unique challenges faced by this year's graduate thesis have demonstrated that our students are imaginative, resilient, and involved. SCI-Arc has emerged as a self-confident community that has the strength to change, the ambition to matter, and the power to envision a reality different from the one we inherited. The class of 2020 has shown that architecture has its own voice, which gives meaning to our human condition. And today, when we celebrate the end of the academic year, more than ever before, it's clear that the core role of thesis and the graduate program at large is to reshape what we understand as being the status quo, to actively pursue the idea that something else could be out there, that is a fundamental and subversive act which stems from the understanding that contemporary problems can't be solved with an old mindset. Collective imagination has to be continuously trained. And as architects at SCI-Arc, we do just that. During the past graduate thesis weekend, an unstoppable wave of energy traversing vibrant monitors and speakers' membranes has shown us that architecture owns a revelatory power and authority. Architecture is an indispensable manifestation of our culture. And you, 2020 class, have shown us what is ahead. You have gifted our community with the invisible power of your imagination. And now you will embark on a chapter of your new life as architects. Today, you must build what you have imagined yesterday, since that is both the essence and the apotheosis of the discipline. Just as a writer must publish, otherwise it's just keeping a diary. Today, it is the first day of that change you envisioned. The good news is that you are not building it alone. This summer, we all have learned the hard way that it is never an individual journey. Intellectual and design values are nurtured by strong communities like the one you have shaped while at SCI-Arc. This summer, the graduate program has been a force of positive change for the entire community. You have shown that great achievements are found when we support one another, no matter the distance. Today, we will graduate with you to the future you have shown is possible. Congratulations, graduate class of 2020.
Julian Viserto. Yeah.
Hi, I'm Sherry Caoxin.
Hello, my name is Wang Shu Chen.
Hi, this is Joy Dai. I just wanted to thank my family and friends for supporting me all these years.
All right.
Wesley Evans.
Luke Falcone.
Hi, I'm William Frazier.
Jesse Gates.
Wendy Guerrero.
Hi, this is Sadvi Jayanth. Mom, Dad, we did it.
Sam Kaufman.
Max. Max.
Amanda Koch. Amanda Koch.
Zoe Catherine Mawetsky.
Cameron McCormick.
Hi. My name is Robert Oshoden. And I want you to know that you're the real heroes.
Hi, this is Recital from the Mark One. Cheers to yours and my future. Bye.
Reza Salehi.
Robert Sipshin.
Erwin Vergara. Someone to thank my mom and my dad and all my friends and also Lynn.
Hey, it's Henry. Just wanted to give a quick shout out to my parents for all their support these past 3 years, even though they've had no idea what I've been up to. Thanks, guys.
Hi, this is Jason Wu. Thank you for family and friends.
Hi, it's
Vincent Young. I want to give a big shout out to my family back home in Canada and all my friends watching online. Thank you so much for your support. I hope to see you guys soon.
Hi, my name is Hao Zhouzhen.
Hi, I'm Jax, Wen Zhizhen.
Hi, my name is Zhu Yuqing.
I, Lin Zi. Guys, this is hard. I'm trying. Well, I need. I think I got it.
Hi, I'm Shidich.
Yun Fei Tao. Yun Fei Tao. Tao Yun Fei.
Hi, everyone. Ozan Chichek here. I want to thank my family, and I'm so happy to graduate.
Hello everyone, it's Tilatora.
It's gonna be here in the frame already. So I can say hi, I'm Lorenzo. Hi, I'm Lorenzo from Lisbon, Portugal. That's it.
Hi, I'm Zepeng.
Christina Griggs.
Nero he Nero he Nero C-H-E-N-X-U-A-N he yo 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 Nero he.
And that is my presentation.
Zhu Chen Hong.
Hello, it's Gregory Kokotis. Congrats, everyone.
Hi, I'm Lei Kaiyun.
Liao Pingzhi.
Nice job, really good job.
我爱你.
Kai Ying Lin.
Hi, I'm Bowen.
Jun Kai, Liu.
Hi, this is Liu Xin from MRK2.
My name is Sixtina Makulam.
Hi, my name is Priyanka Manoj Rajani.
Hi, my name is Amparito Martinez Real.
Yash Mehta.
This is gonna be the best day of my life.
Evgen Özdeş.
Kumaran Partiben.
Hi, my name is Julia Pike.
Hi, I'm Justine Pune.
Hi, I'm Liu Qiao.
Go.
brother.
Kevin Schaefer, your mom and I are very, very proud of you on this special occasion as you receive your master's in architecture.
Congratulations. We love you.
We love you.
Hi, this is Srimoy Sinha.
Andrew Stone.
Jack Hussein Wang.
Hi, I'm Mandy from MOC 2.
Taiyan Wong here. I'm super thankful for everyone that's supporting me along the way.
Hi, I'm Yifan Long. Welcome to my virtual garden world.
Jonathan Warner.
Hello, my name is Yancheng Wu, and thank you for everything Sarah gave to me these 2 years. I'm happy for the graduation today, and I'm glad to be a member of you.
Hello, my name is David Ru. I'm the chair of postgraduate programs. SCI-Arc Edge Center for Advanced Studies in Architecture is comprised of four programs. Architectural Technologies, where we are graduating our future technological innovators. Design of Cities, where we are graduating our future designers of cities. Fiction and Entertainment, where we're graduating our future storytellers and world builders. And Design Theory and Pedagogy, where we are graduating our future design theorists and teachers. The family and friends of these graduates should know that these students did something remarkable this year. In the most difficult of times, these students made a commitment to the future and accepted the proposition that trend is not destiny. All of you danced at the edges of what we know as a civilization. The world needs your intelligence, talent, and foresight like never before. I am so very proud of all of you. This has been a difficult year. Unanticipated challenges were thrown at you. Most of these challenges were not even imaginable before they appeared so suddenly. All of you rose to the occasion, and all of you demonstrated remarkable grace under pressure. I want you to know I am inspired that the work you have done. The phrase grace under pressure is usually attributed as a quote by Hemingway, but it actually comes from a long forgotten article by somebody named Dorothy Parker in an article entitled The Artist's Reward. Parker, profiling Hemingway in this article, describes grace under pressure as a way to think about courage, but more specifically, the courage that it takes to be creative, that is, the courage of artists. Poise in the face of adversity is the artist's reward. In the face of enormous pressure, creativity is a grace, and this grace is yours. There will be good years and bad years in the future, but I hope all of you will take the achievement of this year as something to hold close, something to inspire you during tough moments. You'll always have your work, and your work can answer those questions that the world can't provide. Because we all went through this together, we'll never forget each other. In just a moment, I have the moment coming up that I've been looking forward to all year, the moment when you become a graduate of our school, and I can welcome you now as a colleague. Lastly, you should know something that has been said before, but it is so poignant in this year. The future belongs to you.
Hi, I am Jules Benilush.
Hari Deshpande.
Hi, I'm Jayashree Vardhani Jawahar, and I want to thank my family and friends and everybody who supported me through this, and I'm very excited for my future prospect as a SCI-Arc graduate.
Hi, I'm Evelyn Jungo La Puente from Architectural Technologies. Mom, this one is for you.
Go!
Philippe, come on!
Hi, this is Yi Wuqiao, and here is Prince and Elf.
Jennifer Rubin.
Hi, this is Aiden Tsai.
Tucker Van Loan Hall.
Romano Ion Dyckville.
Larissa Eatson.
Hi, I'm Anush Harutsunyan from Design of Cities 2020.
Hello, this is Xiao. I'm from Design of Cities. Thanks for all the people I met this year. I will miss you all.
Hi, I'm Shanar Moslehi, Design of Cities 2020.
Kelvin Sin, Design of Cities.
Alonso Sodelo from the Design of Cities program.
Hi everyone, this is Xiu Qizhang and I come from Design of Cities. Congratulations for everyone.
Hello everyone, my name is Zhao Zhou. I'm from Design of Cities program. I'm happy to graduate with you guys. Yeah.
Ahmad Badawi, DTP.
I'm Soledad Chamorro, DTP 2020.
Emiliano Espasandín.
Hi, I am Roshanak Ghazalbash.
Oh, I have to say it.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, hold on. My name is Emil Stevens.
James Hollowell.
Takashi Kikawa.
Miriam Coleman.
Miriam Lalou.
Christian Pepper.
Congratulations, SCI-Arc Class of 2020. We in the Office of Development are incredibly proud of each and every one of you.
You rose to the occasion by working through the challenges brought on by the current pandemic.
Thank you for your perseverance, creativity, adaptability, and flexibility, all which are traits of a great architect.
Today, we welcome you to a community of over 5,000 SCI-Arc alumni. As you follow in the footsteps of generations of bold, visionary SCI-Arc alumni who came before you, we know you will uphold this legacy and cannot wait to see everything you accomplish.
Together, we take the lead in reimagining the limits of architecture. Congratulations on all you have accomplished.
Class of 2020, it's been an absolute honor and pleasure teaching many of you. Thank you for all you've taught me as well. Keep publishing, sharing, and promoting your work. We can't wait to see what you do next. This is just the beginning. Wishing you all the very best for the future and more.
Congratulations, everyone. It's been a real pleasure to get to know all of you, and I'm really excited about what you're going to do next. You've worked really hard. You've had a lot of energy, a lot of curiosity, and I'm excited to see all of you go into the world and take that perspective into the fight for what's next for you. So don't give up on that, and we'll miss you very much here at SCI-Arc. Get some rest, but go party. Congratulations.
Congratulations
from Communications.
This is a part in which we recognize some of the thesis projects. First, what we call the Merit Thesis Awards, first for undergrads, then for grad and for postgrad. The undergrad thesis review took place this past April. It was the first event that we have to do virtually, and we are so proud of all what the BArg students did and how they managed and how they expressed their creativity through that. This is the first time that we are announcing the undergrad thesis awards. The Thesis Merit Award, and they are. The first one is a group prize for Anna Anthony and Andrea Velasco. Okay. We got it working. That was the part that wasn't working. We couldn't connect Zoom with everything else. The other Merit Thesis Award is for Dutra Brown. Hi, Dutra. The third Thesis Merit Award is for a group team again, Kaylung Wilson Chang, Jipeng Liu, and Shisho Kiwi Shu. Congratulations to you. The next undergrad thesis merit award is for another group project, Shik Cheng, Desh Hu, and Nicholas Wu. The next undergrad thesis merit award is for Nandar Sally Luing. The next undergrad thesis merit award is for Chu Wen Ong. We find you. It takes a while to find you in the long list of people in Zoom. But it's worth the wait for each of you to get everybody to see you. The next undergrad thesis merit award is for Hong Jing Qing and Ching Feng Jackie Wong. Okay, we're going to move to the last one of the last undergrad merit thesis award is Farasarangan Sinaraha. Congratulations to all of you. Very well deserved, extraordinary work. Now we're going to mention the merit graduate thesis award, the one that we just finished yesterday. We just wrapped up our virtual graduate thesis review yesterday. They were an amazing group of projects this year. And we are fully aware of how much of a challenge this summer was for our AMARC students. And we want to thank you once again and to tell you how proud we are of the work that you produce, how much your intellectual ability and the capacity you produce and you adapted to the medium and the territory that you work in, and you transform the complexity of it into a virtue to try to develop extraordinary work. So, so you know, the Merit Graduate Thesis Award, like the Getty Prize, they were selected by a group of 20 faculty, all the group leaders of the group discussions, plus the history theory advisors. So the result of that will be also, we're going to have an online exhibition of all the extraordinary work, and there will be a special channel channel show on this. So, without further ado, the first graduate thesis merit award goes to Wendy Guerrero. Congratulations. Hey, there, we can see you. Okay, the next graduate thesis merit award is for a group project for Lindsay Ai and Yu Cheng Hong. There you are. The next graduate thesis merit award is for Yusuke Rish Saito. Okay, the next graduate thesis merit award is for Robert Sifken. There you are, Robert. Congratulations. The next graduate thesis merit award is for Sam Kaufman. The next merit graduate thesis award is for Vincent Yang. Vincent, there you are. Congratulations. The next graduate thesis merit award is for Liu Qiao. The next and final of the Grad Merit Thesis Award is for Christina Griggs. Okay, there you are, Christina. Congratulations to all of Merit Graduate Thesis Award of this year. Now, to finish is our endowed prizes. This series of awards are for the top thesis projects in the postgraduate, undergraduate, and graduate programs. These awards are endowed by very close friends and generous and important friends of SCI-Arc, and we are eternally grateful to all of them. The first one that we're going to give is, and I'm thrilled to announce, the winners for the Ming Fan and Craig Hodges Postgraduate Prize for Best Overall Performance in the SCI-Arc program. This prize, we think it represents innovation, creativity, risk-taking, exactly what Ming and Craig have done during all their practice and teaching. So when they decide to endow this prize, the idea was that the recipients will be people who represent those values. So we're very happy to announce that this year we have one winner in each program. So the first one is Tucker Van Leeuwen Hall in Architecture Technologies. Congratulations, Tucker. The second is Ian Romano Dayakville in Design of Cities. Congratulations. The third one is Soledad Chamorro in Design Theory and Pedagogy. Hi, Soledad. Felicitaciones. And the last one in postgraduate is Andre Sakria in Fiction and Entertainment. Congratulations, Andre. So the next one is the Blythe and Tom Main undergraduate thesis prize winner. Blythe and Tom, as I said, they're dear and close friends to the school. Tom Main is one of our founders and current dean of faculty. And both are always committed to support the students and to support and launch the students' career into the next phase. We want to thank, like we all do every year, Blythe and Tom for their generosity. And as I said before, the winner for the undergrad thesis were chosen by the undergrad thesis instructors. And the winners are, and again, this is the first time I've announced it, it's a group project by Abel Maqueira and Phoebe Yu Young. Congratulations. It took 4 months for you to find out. So we are super happy that you were able to be with us. So the final award for the ceremony today is the SCI-Arc Gehry Prize, which was endowed and donated by Frank and Berta Gehry. Again, Frank Gehry and Berta, they always feel very, very committed to the idea to empower young architects and young students. And we are thrilled to have this support. As I mentioned before, for the Merit Awards, this year, we have 5 winners. The school have multiple thesis and multiple voices. And they were chosen by 20 faculty, by vote on the 20 faculty. And so these 5 winners will become what is known now as an insider, the Gehry League. So without further ado, the 5 winners of the Gehry Prize for Grad Thesis 2020 are Zoe Malecki, Saleh Jamseer, Richard Mapes, Richard, congratulations. The next one is Justine Poulin. And finally, Irving Shaifa. Irving, congratulations, terrific job. So, I think all our speakers, Safiya, Dr. Safiya Noble, Vincent Young, Debbie Garcia, our chairs, John Enright, I think they all I want to thank, first of all of them, particularly our three speakers, Dr. Safiya Noble, Vincent Young, and Debbie Garcia. But I want to thank everybody else and all the people who make this possible. But after that, I would like to talk and give a final remarks. So let me thank first our administration, John Enright, Tom Wiscon, Elena Manfardini, and David Rui, the chairs, our faculty. They've done a terrific job the whole year adapting to these circumstances. Our fantastic fearless undergraduate thesis coordinator, Jenny Wu. A special thank to graduate thesis coordinator Florencia Pita. This is her last year in doing this. So she stepped down with a remarkable effort and a fantastic year. The board of trustees, the staff, the graduation creative producer, John Cooper and Damian Jovanovic. Now, let me reflect for a couple of minutes. I know that everybody is desperate to start to celebrate and start the party, but I want to echo some of the thoughts that our speakers put among us. I think we all understand the dimension of the times that we're living in. We understand the dimension of the pandemic. We understand the fight to create an anti-racist society, an anti-racist planet, an anti-racist global community, and also a planet that is in extreme danger as we see it every day and as we suffer in these days in California with the fires. So these are times of crisis. There's no other way around. But echoing Toni Morrison's words, times of crisis is when artists, with creative people, with creative minds get to work, when they work harder, when they get the double. You already proved to yourself, you already proved going through this process that you have the courage, that you have the strength, that you have the civic duty, that you have the generosity, that you have the empathy, that you have the love in your hearts to produce a better place and a better society. So we expect big things from you. We expect for you to be great architects, but most more than anything, be great human beings, being great citizens, be subject to another, work collectively, work for your communities, work to do an impact. Use, as Safiya said, use the ability to intersect technology and social change. Use your capacity to have radical design and speculative ideas with a radical social agenda. As simple as it is, let's go and do a better place. Do not be patient. Patience is completely overrated. You cannot wait. The time doesn't allow us for that. You have to start working right away. You have to start, jump on it. As I said, all of you have the talent, the imagination, the desire to be all that. And most of all, All of us, we experience from you a sense of community and a sense of conversation that has been forever changed how the school is going to move forward. So, class of 2020, you are an extraordinary class. This is an extraordinary year. I don't think any of us will ever forget these times. We are grateful to you. We are grateful to your families. You haven't done it without the support of your family and your loved ones. It's always a team effort. So if we were in our parking lot, this will be the time I will tell, rise up and take a bow. But since we are in the virtual space, let's bring all of you up. And I wish we could celebrate together in person. But know that we all together in spirit, and then you are forever part of the SCI-Arc family. So let us offer to all of you our deepest congratulations and our deepest love. Thank you, everyone. This is our show. I hope you all join us for the virtual reception, the follow-up. We will have first a special dance performance interlude. After that, our guests who are friends, family, SCI-Arc faculty, staff, please click on your reception Zoom link to join the party, and we'll see you there. Again, we have nothing but gratitude, pride, and love for all of you. Class of 2020, go and conquer the world. Thank you.